Welcome back, Health Accumulators. So we're talking about nebulizers today. You know, among both healthy and immunocompromised people, the number one problem that we run into, causing death, premature death that is, in the world, is pneumonia. Nobody wants pneumonia, right? And you know, this has been true long before the advent of the the current viral illness that starts with a C, ends with 19, that's been going around. Pneumonia has been a deal breaker for a lot of people that died out way earlier than they needed to because of some infectious agent. This is a major reason why I recommend every household have a nebulizer. Have a nebulizer available in your home. Stick it in a cupboard. Hopefully you never have to use it, and that $30 just sits up there in the closet somewhere. But having it in the home and having somebody who's proficient with the nebulizer, it can be a game changer. It could really be you being at home chilling or you being in the ER. So our lungs, they have this insane surface area, and they are always in contact with our external environment. And this surface area is like 100 meters squared, which is roughly equivalent to like 1,100 square feet or so. That's a lot of surface area. And our nasal passage, our nose, we gotta breathe to stay alive. So our lungs are always in contact. Our respiratory tract is always in contact with our external environment. And this makes them really vulnerable. I mean, great vulnerability to pathogens, to environmental toxicants, as well as just this great opportunity potentially to get stuff, get medicine, get antioxidants, anti-inflammatory agents into our lungs to support our body, because there is all the surface area. So there's both the problem in that there's all the surface area and our lungs are always responding to the external environment, but there's also the fact that we can utilize that to the benefit of our body and in the healing and in helping and enabling healing. So thankfully, God is awesome. He's the creator of the universe, creator of our being, and in his wisdom, his perfect wisdom, he saw that we are extremely vulnerable to pathogens, and we need essentially a mucus gel layer, a mobile one that allows us to essentially grab a hold of pathogens, cover them with mucus, and then stick them on this little elevator, this mucociliary escalator almost, we could call it, that will then take those toxicants, those pathogens back out of our body or out of our lung tissue. So we swallow them, spit them out, end up in our Kleenex, breathe them out. But sometimes that elevator, that mucus layer, it gets overwhelmed. Our lungs get just overwhelmed because of inflammation, because of maybe chronic illnesses, because of poor breathing patterns, mouth breathing all the time, or maybe a chronic or acute illness like we've seen going on in the last couple of years, and we're unable to clear the secretions. And this is where nebulization can be a real lifesaver to help us clear these secretions. And nebulizers, basically they turn medicine, powdered medicine, into an aerosolized substance that we breathe in deeply. And this medicine goes deep into our lung tissue, deep into our respiratory tract, and can act as an antioxidant, can act as a mucolytic, can act as an anti-inflammatory, an expectorant. And I've seen this so many times over and over again where the nebulizer, whether it's like a steroid, like budesonide or antioxidant like glutathione, a really strong mucolytic / antioxidant like N-acetylcysteine, which of course we've talked about NAC, NAC, we've talked about many times, or even like a 3% diluted hydrogen peroxide, and even normal saline, where these nebulizing these can be just a huge game changer and completely change the course of a patient's illness simply by getting medicine directly to that tissue without it being this, because one thing, say you take dexamethasone, you take prednisone in pill form, that might be helpful, but it's going systemically in a hurry, right? You got to take big doses of it to make a difference. Whereas when you nebulize things, they're going directly to this tissue, first. They're going into the lung tissue first, as opposed to going systemically, then coming back. And so they can have direct effect right here, right now, when nebulized. I mean, I would love to say, you know, there's loads of double-blind, placebo-controlled crossover studies on these nebulized substances. There is not, unfortunately. I mean, there's lots of studies generally, but not you know, huge studies. So on, you know, like acute respiratory distress disorder or syndrome, pneumonia, bronchitis. But I can tell you this: there are many case studies, many of my own patient personal experiences, many of the doctors I've talked to who've had insane results, you know, great results with loads of patients, and seen, you know, a dramatic turnaround when the substance, the medication, the antioxidant, like I was saying, the mucolytic, is delivered directly to the respiratory tract, as opposed to, you know, say, even like something like glutathione, taking that glutathione, which, you know, I would, great idea, take it orally, gel, you know, liposomal glutathione kind of thing. But, you know, when you drill that directly to the respiratory tract, you know, I've seen much, much more improvement when people are drilling it directly there via like nebulization. So this is an awesome opportunity that I would not want to leave on the bench. And I would highly recommend, you know, talk to your doctor about, you know, would that benefit me? You know, if I have a respiratory issue, my kid has a respiratory issue, would nebulizing, you know, either medications or antioxidants, mucolytics, these kind of things, would those potentially be of more benefit with less side effect potential by going the nebulized route versus you know, just taking large doses orally and having this entire systemic effect? So, I mean, if you can decrease inflammation, if you can help clear mucus better, if you can help with lung spasticity, if you can help you know, with the antioxidant capacity of the lung tissue and just like clearance of these toxicants and pathogens, I mean, what could be better? I mean, that's like opportunity knocking, right? So I think you want to talk to your doctor about it, because you know, this could be the difference between you being stable, being able to stay at home, and, you know, emergency, you know, being in a hospital situation that is not necessary for you. So one thing I would mention when you get a nebulizer, and this is like the face mask for a good nebulizer, is I would get one that completely covers your face. See, cover my nose, cover my mouth, as opposed to ones that are like just sitting out here and almost or more like a mister, which I've seen some people have, and I mean, those just don't work as effectively. Because you want something you can literally breathe in deep through your nose, pull on the diaphragm, pull all that, you know, the medication or the antioxidant, or the you know, whatever your doctor's recommended. You want to be able to pull it all the way deep into the respiratory tract to get full effect. So look for one that's more like of this variety. See that? And then, I mean, this is the one I use a lot for my family, recommend in my office. I do not sell them in my office, but these are the ones I recommend. The Cool Mist Compressor System, it's pretty cool. Works really efficiently. I've had patients have, you know, great results, and it's really easy to use. I'll show you in an upcoming video, you know, how to use a nebulizer appropriately, but it is pretty self-explanatory, the process of it. All right, so I'm Dr. Matt. Like, share, you know, subscribe, tell your people, your friends, your family about maybe have a nebulizer on hand just in case, so that you could, you know, perform therapy immediately, as opposed to, you know, they don't have one at the drugstore, so you gotta wait, you know, 2 days to get one in the mail, 3 days to get one in the mail. It's like, man, that's 72 hours we wasted. And I see it nonstop. Or you get in a situation where there's all these people getting sick all the time, or at a particular time, and then, you know, everybody's going for it, and you can't get your hands on a nebulizer, which did happen, you know, about a year and a half ago. So get one now while things are a little more chill. Have it on hand, and then you know, if the situation arises, boom, you'll be ready, and you won't have to you know, be racing around trying to find one. And you might, you know, find one that's not as good, that doesn't work as well, that doesn't have the, you know, the face masks, that kind of thing. All right, hope this helps. Cumulate help, people. Talk to you guys later.